Good afternoon. A warm welcome to everyone as we celebrate this third Sunday of Easter. Just a reminder that the creed can be found on the inside front cover of your bulletin. The music is on a yellow sheet inside of your bulletin. And if you would like to follow along with the readings this afternoon, they can be found in that back section of your hymnal at number 1068. So as we begin our celebration, let's rise and join together with Sing with All the Saints.
Thanks a lot for being here. Wouldn't you rather be golfing? What a beautiful day, though, huh? Just in tomorrow, too. So it's fantastic. So thanks for being here as we continue the Easter season. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In the gospel, it talks about the disciples recognizing Jesus in the breaking of the bread. We are called to do the same, to recognize Jesus in what we do here. We're lucky to be here. And so we turn to the Lord now and trust his mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the author of life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you were raised from the dead so that we may live forever. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And Lord Jesus, you shine the light of salvation upon us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us praise our God by singing the Gloria.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. Glory to God, glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Amen. Amen. Amen.
And let us pray. May your people exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
And let us receive, be nourished by the word of God. Ignorance excuses us before we hear the gospel. Now we're responsible for what we do.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, and the God of our fathers has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence, whom, when he had decided to release him. You denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand, through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Keep me safe, O God. You are my hope. You are my hope, O God. Keep me safe, O God. You are my hope. You are my hope, O God. I say to God, you are my
Even sin cannot separate us from God.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, "I know him," but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Give the glory and the honor to the Lord. Alleluia.
The disciples are given evidence of Jesus' resurrection. The Lord be with you. I read from the Gospel according to Luke. The disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled, and why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish, and he took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Again, thanks for being here and thanks for joining us online. Those of you who've been in the parish for a while know that my music style is I listen to the rock classics. Music that I grew up with in high school and college, and now that I'm this age, I and my music are classic. Don't call a person old, just say, "You're a classic." And So I would go to concerts all the time, and I still go to concerts with my brother Chuck, who likes the same type of music, but we go to now like Meyer Theater, where you see bands, like about a month ago, a band came here and played Led Zeppelin music, fantastic, from Philadelphia. I've told you, I think, or I've certainly mentioned to other people, the favorite concert I ever attended was back in the mid-70s in St. Paul, Minnesota, when I was going to St. John's in Collegeville. It was in a theater about 2,000 people it could hold. It was Kansas and Queen. Yeah, no kidding. Both were on the rise. Queen had put out an album called A Night at the Opera. And you all know the song. Bohemian Rhapsody was the classic song, and they just shot up. Kansas, I think Dust in the Wind had come out. And so they were just on the rise. It was a phenomenal concert. This past week, I get National Catholic Reporter, and I get the emails from them. They had an article referring, one of the examples in the article was Freddie Mercury. Freddie Mercury was the late lead singer of Queen. Phenomenal voice, phenomenal. And again, the album came out in 75, and off they went. The article was talking about the wounds that we have in life. And the article was written by Michael Leach, even talking about his wife. But referring to Mercury, it was talking about him singing a song, I think when he was 40. I think it was around 1980 or something like that, The Great Pretender. The Great Pretender was a classic song in 1955 by the Platters. The point of the song was, I can look at you and you can tell me, oh, you're looking great, you know, everything's going well, you know, but you're just pretending. Because inside you is a lot of hurt and wounds. But we all do this. We're the great pretender. A lot of people don't know what's going on in their life. And in the article, it talked about Freddie Mercury. If anybody who's seen a picture of Freddie Mercury, know his teeth and his jaw are out of line. Just different. And as a kid, he just got hammered for that, the way he looked. You know, kids can be pretty mean. And he, if you look at his face, something's not right there. He looks different. And then, of course, in the 70s for him, his sexual orientation, it was homosexual. You think it's tough now? Go back to the 70s. And he would be right out there. And just talked about he was hammered. And when he was 7 years old, he was sent to a boarding school. And then, of course, hammered there. And again, how the press treated him over the years. And they came to this song saying he was singing that song because he was the great pretender. He could get in front of 1,000 people and put on the greatest show in the world. Fabulous musician, fabulous singer. But in here was a lot of wounds. And then again, we have the Lord standing in front of us again today with his wounds. Now, when you think of Jesus Christ, do you focus on his wounds? I think we focus on he's risen from the dead. Easter. Today we gathered for a 40-year-old's funeral, Robbie. The only thing that keeps us going is we know we're going to see him again because of the risen Lord. And so as we gather here, in light of that article, and I'd be glad to send it to you. If you want email, go to the website, email me, say you want the article, I'll send it to you. But I think the point of the article, the point of Jesus still having his wounds, is you're not defined by those wounds. So don't define yourself by what happened back in high school or grade school or that relationship that broke off, etc., etc., etc. We define ourselves by the risen Lord. And those of us who get the opportunity to receive the Eucharist receive the body of Christ because he loves us. And those of you who are second graders or younger, soon you'll have your first communion. Now, Michael Leach in the article, because his wife went through a lot of that, took a different practice for his own life, acknowledging his own wounds, and the people he's meeting have their own wounds too. So I want to just close with this little quote from his article. Again, I'd be glad to send it to you. He says this, "Here's the practice I've committed to even when I'm down and out and feeling blue. When the phone rings before I answer it, or before I call someone myself, and they have yet to pick up the receiver, I say, I love you. Love changes what might have been an ordinary or even troubling conversation into an encounter more valuable than a gold record. When I walk down the street, I smile at whoever is walking toward me and say, hi. Realizing that this individual doesn't want to harm me, but is in fact just like me." I thought, that's Easter. That's holy moments. So thanks for listening. Again, if you want that article, go to the website, send me your email, and I'll fire it out to you. I invite you to grab that blue little sheet there as we pray the prayer in the front there. Those who are visiting, it's called A Reconciling Love. If you got time tonight, listen to some Queen in Kansas. Classics. So let us pray. Loving Father, you sent your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to reconcile the world to you. Grant that our hearts may be open to your revelation in the Eucharist and in the world. May your Spirit enliven us, that we may spread our faith to all we encounter. Through Christ our Lord, amen. If you're able to, I invite you to stand at this time as we profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life to world to come. Amen. Gather around this Easter table to be recognized Jesus in the breaking of the bread. We take time to offer these prayers.
For the church, that we may be open to receive forgiveness and healing from our loving God, we pray. For all world leaders, that they may not lose patience with one another, and that they will renew their efforts to end conflicts through negotiations, we pray. For each of us called by name and claimed by God, that we may come to know Jesus in the breaking of the bread and the sharing of the scriptures, so that Jesus may shine forth in our daily lives, we pray. For the sick and those who care for them, that they may know the healing touch of God's tender love and mercy, we pray. For all who struggle with life, that they may be open to all the ways God is working in their lives and to the life-giving possibilities before them, we pray. For those on our prayer tree, for all who have asked for our prayers, for the intentions in our hearts, and for our loved ones and parishioners who have died, including Robbie McMenemy, and especially Dennis Borley, whom we remember today, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, we ask you to hear these prayers spoken, the prayers we bring in our hearts. We all have our wounds, Lord. We ask for your healing and also sensitivity to all people because they have wounds too. We're called to be Easter disciples. Help us show your compassion and love daily. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated as the gifts are brought to the altar this time.
As a sign of their spirit of sharing, our children are invited to place their offering in the small basket near the front of the altar.
Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted, God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your exalted church. And as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the
and
Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him you have been pleased to renew all people, giving us all a share in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and by the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore, he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna in the
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, entered willingly into his passion for everyone. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, and offers it to us, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, to be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, to be poured out for you and for many for forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body of Christ may gather into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, and your entire people. Remember our family members and our friends who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, at the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. And we'll sing the Amen. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and form of divine teaching, let us pray for another in our families as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. And the peace, Lord, be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace.
Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ.
A voice to be heard, a part in the song. The hands of a child in hands that are wrinkled, for young and for old, the right to belong. And God will delight when we are creators of justice and joy. Yes, God will delight when we are creators of justice. And joy. For just and unjust, a place at the table, abuser abused with need to forgive. In anger, in hurt, a mindset of mercy, for just and unjust, a new way to live. And God will delight when we of justice and joy. Yes, God will delight when we are creators of justice, justice and joy. For everyone born a place at the table, to live without fear and simply to be, to work, to speak out, to witness and worship, for everyone born the right to be free. And God will delight when we are creators of justice and joy. Yes, God will delight when we are creators of justice, justice and joy.
Thank you.
you have the bulletin with you, we'll pray the St. Michael's Prayer. And again, our intention is to end war in our world. And as I was coming over to church, supposedly Iran sent drones at Israel. I mean, people just don't get it. It's not going to solve anything. So let's pray this prayer to end of war as we pray. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the divine power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruins of souls. Amen. Last weekend, we talked about the summer kickoff a little bit, and I forgot a couple things to the youth here, or the young at heart, or what we call classics. We need ice cream pails for the booyah. So in between now and the kickoff, could you eat a gallon of ice cream for the parish? So again, we need these buckets for the booyah takeout. Also, the bucket raffle, I forgot to mention, they need to have the items in by Memorial Day weekend, because then they got to get everything together. So that last week is pretty hectic. So if you would have any items that you're going to donate, again, at least $75, has to be new. Donate by Memorial Day weekend. If you're not a shopper, if you want to just put an envelope, cash or whatever, or check for bucket raffle and let the committee shop for you, they'd be glad to do that as well. So again, also want to just alert you to a little announcement in the bulletin. On May 4th, Saturday morning, weather permitting like this, we're going to spread mulch around our property. You can tell walking around here, it's been 2 years, all you do is see the matting now, pretty much it's all been blown away. So bring your wheelbarrows and rakes and shovels, whatever, for May 4th, Saturday. It starts at 8 o'clock. We're going to decorate again mulch at the Holy Name of Jesus House by our flagpole and all the shrubs around here. So be glad to have you here working out as a family here, doing that work again May 4th. So I stand now for closing prayer. So let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may God bless us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. This Mass ends. Go and share the joy of the gospel. Thanks be to God.
Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea, raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made, let all the earth rejoice. I will give thanks to you, my Lord. You have answered my plea. You have saved my soul from death. You are my strength and my song. Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice. Death has lost and all is life. Sing of the glory of God. Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice. Let all the